With Kanye's unreleased Life of the Party video from 2020 recently leaking, it got me curious just how many music videos he's made and then ended up scrapping over the years. I mean, we all know the infamous New Body video with the black lights and stuff, but there's actually a ton more music videos Kanye made that were straight up filmed and finished and then put in the vault for all of eternity. In order to get an idea of just how many ideas in total Kanye has scrapped, let's go through every unreleased music video that I could find in order going from oldest to newest, and all of these have had some or all of their footage surface on the internet over the past few years. Starting off way back in the College Dropout days, Kanye actually fully finished a video for Spaceship probably sometime in 2003 or 2004. It eventually leaked online a couple years after being made, but it seems nobody really gave it a second thought until Kanye himself uploaded the long lost video to his official website as part of his West Day Ever campaign on June 26, 2020, that coincided with his partnership announcement with Gap. This video is pretty good, honestly. It's got Kanye, Consequence, and GLC, and definitely perfectly represents the themes of Spaceship in a visual format. I think it would have been a big deal if it had dropped back in 2004. After that, we've got a music video Kanye, GLC, T.I., and Paul Wall filmed for the song Drive Slow from Late Registration, which released on August 30th, 2005. I would say I like this one a bit less than Spaceship. It feels a bit more uninspired and doesn't really live up to the amazing imagery Kanye is capable of displaying with a lot of his other unreleased videos.
He had dreams of caprices, drove by the teachers, even more by police. How he get the cash today, his father passed away. Left him with a little something, 16, he was stunting. I'll be sure, nigga, with the hair all wavy. Hit Lakeshore, girls go all crazy. Hit the freeway, go at least about 80.
Next, moving on to Graduation, we've got a full video that Kanye made for Champion that he would end up scrapping. I don't even think Kanye is physically in this one, as it features like a hand puppet rendition of him in the Graduation 2008 era with the shutter shades, doing various things a champion would do, I suppose, like racing and training and whatnot. So like, I wouldn't call this low effort because it's still very fun and I enjoyed it, but Kanye isn't in it at all, so I'm curious why he chose not to release it.
That shit. So if you gon' do it just like this.
Did you realize that you are a champion?
When it feel like living's harder than dying. For me, giving up's way harder than trying. Lauryn Hill said her heart was in Zion. I wish her heart still was in.
Now we've arrived at 808s and Heartbreak, which had quite a few dope videos like Stronger, Heartless, and Welcome to Heartbreak, but did you know a full video was made and finished for RoboCop that never released? This one features both Kanye and Amber Rose in a stop motion format with some live action shots of Kanye spliced in. I really like this one, and the stop motion looks quite nice, so I'm confused why Kanye ended up scrapping it, cause at this time he was obviously still dating Amber Rose, and this style of video perfectly fits 808s. In addition to RoboCop, Kanye also worked on a video for Streetlights, but this one is way, way more unfinished, and we basically only have a proof of concept that Kanye made. It looks very 3D generated and artificial, and was only supposed to be the first draft simulated concept of what the video might look like. Unfortunately, we don't know whether or not it was worked on beyond this. Tough to say what the end product would have looked like from just this early concept, but the video had some solid ideas for sure.
Lonely happened to be just like moments passing in front of me. So I hopped in the cab and I paid my fare. See, I know my destination.
Jumping ahead to 2014, Kanye actually had a full video made that combined both All Day and I Feel Like That. In fact, the I Feel Like That video that most people are familiar with comes from this combined concept where it was paired with All Day, with the entire thing being filmed in a similar style. This one was directed by Steve McQueen and was played by Kanye for several fans in Paris, so he clearly really liked it. And I think if I Feel Like That had ended up releasing, we definitely would have gotten this one. Because he did drop All Day, so he kind of got halfway there.
All day, nigga. Take you to get this fly. All day, nigga. Tell you P.O. how long you been high. All day, nigga.
Then we've got a video that Kanye filmed for Part 2, basically at the same time they shot the Panda video, because Part 2 is just Kanye's remix of Panda. It seems the Part 2 video may have never been fully finished, but they for sure shot footage for it, because we have the Panda video, and then this footage specifically done for Part 2 that Luka Sabbat posted on Vine way back in 2016. After that, we've got the infamous New Body video that I'm sure a lot of you guys have at least heard of. This one was made for the Yandy version of the song, made in 2018, while Kanye was still planning on dropping Yandy. The full video hasn't leaked yet, but we've got tons of images from the set as well as some short snippets, so we know generally what it would have looked like. According to the leakers that have the video, Kanye and Ty Dolla $ign are dressed up in fursuits at some point in this one. New Body, the song, would get a ton more changes in 2019 and 2020, becoming very secular, so the original video definitely would not have fit Kanye's gospel vision had the song ended up releasing.
Hey, yo. You may fuck me, you fuck the old body. You may fuck Nikki, you fuck Nicole body. Ain't no miles on this here new body. Put their heads, these bitches is nobody.
Along with New Body, Kanye also filmed a video for We Got Love off Yandy, literally in the parking lot of TMZ. This wild incident occurred after Kanye had gone on SNL on September 28th, and it seems he got the genius idea to bring some Sunday Service Choir members and post up in the TMZ parking lot to film a music video. Honestly, they are vibing super hard in the video. I feel like it would have been kinda insane had it released, and of course We Got Love is a great song.
I'll pay with the honey. Love is the new money. That's my frequency.
You gon' take that wristband home. That petite party been over. Don't need makeup to dress you up. I gave birth on the bathroom floor.
Make some noise.
Moving into 2019, Kanye worked on a video for Water that this time in his album Development featured his vocals with Aunt Clemens, but no Sunday Service, so a little bit different to the version that would release on the album. The full thing hasn't come out yet, but we do have some clips posted on Instagram, and this one looks interesting, I would say. The Jesus is King videos in general were pretty good in my opinion, and I feel like this one probably wouldn't have lived up to Closed on Sunday and Follow God. Now finally ending in the most recent Donda era, we've got the video that Kanye made for Blood of the Lamb, which was posted to both his Twitter account and website in July of 2020, when he was going super hard grinding trying to finish the album for a drop. He ended up removing the video from both areas and completely scrapped the song from the album, but I remember the day that he uploaded this was like the most insane thing ever. I really felt like the album was guaranteed to drop at this time.
And plus it's only 21 days to break a habit. Mama, I need you to tuck me in. I done made some mistakes and they rubbed it in. Boy, I know you and grandma had enough for them. Boy, why I gotta be so stubborn then? Boy, I'm doing this one for y'all, so we can end racism once and for all.
Then we've got an early version of the 24 music video that Kanye made in March of 2021, and this one utilizes the July 2020 version of 24 and is also quite a bit different. It still features a lot of the same footage from the release video from later on in 2021, but with new footage of the Sunday Service Choir, and of course the song version is entirely different.
Thank you. listen. What a vision, wonderful vision. What a vision. Pray we listen. Pray we listen. Washed us in blood. Pessimism.
And to wrap up this modern era of scrapped Kanye videos, we've got the Life of the Party one that just recently leaked with like a ton of other Donda 2020 stuff. I don't think we know 100% when this was made, but probably sometime in mid to late 2020 if I had to guess. The Donda music videos were definitely interesting, so I don't know if I can really say this one is worse than what we got with Hurricane and 24, but Life of the Party is fire, so I guess it would have been cool had it released, but it kind of gives me Wash Us in the Blood vibes.
From a slip up, fake signatures, from fake managers, it all damage ya. Good Lord, give them enough of their own rope to hang them with. The paparazzi never really got where my angle is. They treat my married life like some type of entanglement. My neighbors still dissing, wonder why I ain't saying.
Honestly, in reality, Kanye has probably filmed twice that many videos, we just don't know about them, and we'll probably never see their footage. I feel like in his head, he has an idea he could use to make a music video for literally any song he releases, so that's why he so often has unreleased and scrapped video ideas. Of all these, I feel like the New Body music video is the obvious choice for what people would see as the best or most highly sought after scrapped video. It just sucks that we have so little real looks into it, but maybe that could change in the future. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed, feel free to leave a like and subscribe to my channel for more videos like this, and let me know down in the comments which unreleased video you liked the most out of all of these.